Hey guys, Theo from CloudNC again. We've just wrapped our first day at the EMO Machine Tool Show, and my god, this place is so big. That's the first thing I noticed. There's so many halls here. I've walked maybe 15 to 20 kilometers, and I've still only seen what feels like 15% of the show. I've spoken to less than 1% of the exhibitors. And the second thing that I noticed is this is not just a machine tool show. This isn't just a place where you go and speak to your providers like your Mazaks, your DMGs, your Haases. It's not just a place where you go and talk about tools and CAM software. No, there's actually all of the individual pieces of machine tool on display here. You want to go and speak to 15 companies that make ball screws? They're right here. You want to speak to 10 companies that make Mr. Oil extractors? They're here too. All of the subcontractors that build the parts that go into your machine tool are here on display as well. Because I suppose if you are a machine tool company, then this is the place that you come to collaborate and partner and buy from your subcontractors to find out what the new technologies are that you can then take to build better machine tools. So I've also come across a couple of maybe better user interfaces, not very much, but the sorts of things that we're trained to expect from being modern software users, things that take very little time to train on. Now, what I'm going to spend the next few days looking for is actual innovations. Nobody needs to see like another cutting tool that's 1% faster or a machine that's 3% bigger. I think we've all seen this before. So what I'm going to be focused on is finding things that I have not actually seen before and bringing those things to you, anybody who can't make it to the show. Okay, so without further ado, let's go find some interesting stuff.